A few months ago, someone on the street asked Oh The Urbanity why there are so many cats around the city of Montreal. Having noticed this ourselves and been pleasantly surprised by the free companionship, we didn't really have a good answer. We'll try to shed some light on the matter in this video.
Quebecers like their cats. According to the Montreal Gazette, there were 1.8 million cats in the province in 2020, and 49% of Quebec households have at least one pet. What's more, French-speaking Quebecers seem to be a little more into cat ownership than English-speaking Quebecers.
And if, like us, you've spent much time wandering around the residential neighborhoods of Montreal, especially in the warmer months, you've probably noticed the abundance of urban tigers weaving in and out of streets and alleyways, too.
It's not uncommon to see Montrealers stopped on the sidewalk, petting or Instagramming one of these neighborhood cats. And the great majority of them look healthy, well-fed, and are pretty friendly to humans. The cats, we mean.
With all these cats wandering around with no owner in sight, you might think that people aren't taking care of their pets. But Montreal actually does take pet ownership pretty seriously, at least recently. As of January 2020, all indoor and outdoor cats in the city must have a microchip, permit, tag, and proof of sterilization.
While there are some compelling theories about the street cats in Montreal, we think the reason is a bit less sinister, maybe related to Montreal's signature plex housing, which is denser than detached suburban-style homes, but more ground-oriented than apartment or condo towers.
The population density means that there are lots of people with cats, and the easy access to the ground means that it's more likely that you'll let your cat outside or that it'll sneak out. Neighborhoods of residential towers probably have lots of cats too, but they're usually not able to make it to the ground outside.
A related phenomenon to the number of cats outside is the number of missing cat signs stapled to utility poles and fences. They're usually pretty creative, with details about the personality of the cat, maybe a cat selfie with a bow tie, and information about where the animal was last seen.
While interesting to see in a pretty normal pet owner response to a missing animal, the prevalence of these posters seems to suggest that life in the city is pretty hard on these cats, with so many becoming lost, hit by cars, or mistakenly taken in by new owners believing them to be strays.
With that said, we definitely prefer these street companions to the raccoons of Toronto, and as long as there are so many in our midst, we might as well enjoy the perks.